We have word that Dave Ayers, 42 years of age, emergency support goaltender, will be forced into service here for the Hurricanes. And here he comes, number 90 for the Carolina Hurricanes is Dave Ayers. So he's been a spare goaltender in these parts when both the Toronto Marlies and the American Hockey League, the Toronto Maple Leafs, have needed an extra goaltender. He'll get the warm-up. This is the only time you can do this. According to the reports, the highest level of hockey he has played is Junior B, which is a step below Junior A, which is a step below Major Junior.
Loved what the guys did to go out and welcome him on the ice. You can only imagine what his nerves are like right now, what his heart rate is like right now.
Not exactly color coordinated, but that doesn't matter. What a moment here. Self pass, he'll get after it. Ayers out to play it. He'll move it, good job, to a safe area.
Yeah, that'll settle him down, you hope. Nice little play to reverse that puck.
Aho over the line, moves it in. Kane's feed it across, this way for Teuvo Teräpäinen, out in front, rejected by Anderson, they score!
Hey, typically speaking, I'd say that's a routine play by a goaltender, but when you're an emergency backup,
nothing's routine.
That is consequential by Ayers. Oh.
Tavares, near point, snapped in by Barry, injured Kane. Tavares, a shot, he scores! John Tavares, right along the ice. And Toronto is within two. Pass Barry Kapanen. He'll turn away from Van Riemsdyk. Midpoint Barry, a shot, loose, they score! Pierre Engvall! And there's nothing the goaltender could do about that one. And Riemsdyk along the boards, Tavares centering pass, a chance, Ayers said no! It's loose in the crease, he's got it! Austin Matthews chopping at one, and David Ayers comes up big.
What a night tonight, what haven't we seen?
David Ayers actually has a connection to this organization. A few weeks ago, he sat on the bench for the Charlotte Checkers of the American Hockey League when they were in Toronto to face the Marlies. Back in the net for the third, his wife Sarah in the building tonight. And if you follow her on Twitter, understandably, she's been freaking out, Jim.
Stretch pass, Austin Matthews cutting on Gardner to the slot. A shot blocked by Van Riemsdyk. The rebound off the stick of Ayers. It goes high, chopped in. Ayers again says no. He's got it.
And the capacity crowd here, all the Leaf fans, they're cheering for Ayers.
The Kings can't get it out. Kerfoot, high man, what a save!
Under the elbow on the blocker's side, and he squeezes and holds on. That's a gem.
40 years ago today was Miracle on Ice, Jim, but I don't know what you make of this so far tonight.
This is a miracle on ice.
They might put this guy in the plane and fly him back to Raleigh for a parade tomorrow.
Yeah.
3 seconds left, here's Clifford, stopped by David Ayers. The Carolina Hurricanes surround him and defeat the Toronto Maple Leafs, 6-3. I'm sure that sweater goes to the Hall of Fame. Number 90 will live on for the Carolina Hurricanes, 42 years of age.
Here he is, named one of the stars of the game, and there's another first, and something he probably never thought he'd get a chance to do. And good for the fans here to show their appreciation of what he had to do tonight.
It's been great. Obviously, that second period was a little shaky, but I told the boys in the dressing room, once we come up for the third, I'll be settled down and ready to win this one.
I mean, your last game of record that we could find was Allen Cup hockey 5 years ago. How would you just describe what tonight was?
It was awesome. Obviously, the time of my life out there. I've been on this ice many times without fans. Put fans in the mix and it's a whole different game, obviously. But hey, once in a lifetime, I'll take it.
So here's the score, 1-0. But this is one of the nuances of our game that I absolutely love. You are looking at the emergency goalie, Byron Spriggs. Who's Byron Spriggs? He's 26 years old. He played for the University of Manitoba, where he posted a 3.73 GAA, .897 save percentage in 24 games in the 18-19 campaign. Winnipeg, Manitoba native, attended Manitoba Moose camp on a tryout. Here he is, one play away from going in to play goalie in the National Hockey League. I love it.
You might have seen the Lightning beat the St. Louis Blues 4-2 on Thursday night. If you're Kyle Connan, you will remember much more than the score. Thanks to a series of luck that was at least good for him, Amalie Arena's emergency backup goalie got to spend one day as a member of the St. Louis Blues. Oh, what a night it was. And today he talked to Fox 13's Evan Axelbank about it.
Who hasn't wished their name was on a real jersey?
You know, I walk in and my jersey's in the stall. And
who hasn't dreamed of skating onto the ice in the NHL? Who hasn't wondered what it would feel like to warm up with the pros? Until last night, they were Kyle Konen's dreams too.
Chance of making the NHL, even if you get drafted, less than 1%.
This is the moment the dreams became real.
My heart rate was just through the roof. It's crazy. It's almost like I'm watching someone else go out there and do it.
Say hello to Amalie Arena's emergency backup goalie. Every arena has to have an extra, just in case both the starter and backup on one of the two teams is unable to play. Ordinarily, he just sits in the stands and watches, with his gear nearby. Here's how he describes the league he normally plays in Brandon.
Some guys, you show up drinking beers. Sometimes you got beer in your bottle on the bench, and all the guys go out for beers after the game.
But don't let this beer leaguer fool you. The 23-year-old has played in leagues where players get drafted from, so he's almost certainly better than anyone you know. As Amalie Arena's emergency backup, he often takes shots during Lightning practices. Yesterday, it so happened that one of the Blues' regular goalies was sick, and they didn't have time to call up a minor leaguer. So he was needed to sit on the bench in uniform, just in case. Because it was technically his first game in the NHL, the Blues followed tradition and allowed him to lead the team onto the ice.
In my head, I was just doing a normal pace around, going calm, and I watched the videos after, and I literally went out there 100 miles an hour, full sprint.
His family made sure to buy tickets in the front row and took a lot of the videos you're seeing.
If this is gonna happen to anybody, an opportunity like this, and someone's gonna have the most fun with it, it would be Kyle.
Sadly for Kyle, he watched the whole game from the bench as the Blues goalie lost, but survived. The team signed a stick for him, gave a whole bunch of swag, and of course, that jersey.
Nothing compares to being in an arena like Amalie with 18,000 there, and just, it's crazy.
Who cares how you make it to the NHL? Evan Axelbank, Fox 13 News.
Tonight, age 28, assistant coach of the New Jersey Titans of the NAHL. He had quite a sense of humor about this assignment in the pregame availability today. Look, he called it the perfect storm. For an amateur tryout guy, he says, if this game is in LA, I'm not getting the phone call. We all know the deal.
Wow, these are take on a life of its own. What a great story and a great experience, I would believe, for Kyle. I mean, he probably had to pinch himself when he got the call, and he's enjoying the NHL life as far as the meals, right, Terrence? He couldn't believe it, and he's right. They're spoiled.
Quick shot fired off the stick.
It's been a ton of fun. I mean, all the guys have been great. Some of the best parts have been the reactions from family, friends, and I actually coach a hockey team in the North American League, the New Jersey Titans. So the reaction from all of my players and everything has been, it's been pretty surreal, to be honest. So I'm just trying to enjoy every minute until this little ride ends here. Yeah, it's wild. Like I was just saying, it's kind of been the perfect storm of an ATO goalie, right? Like if they were in LA tonight, I'm sure I wouldn't have been on the team plane. So the fact that I was able to hop on the bus last night, 7:30, leaving the arena over there, and then, you know, hotels, meal. I see why everybody likes this league so much.
And now look at this. This weird season, John, just got stranger and stranger. The emergency backup goaltender here with the Dallas Stars is now playing for the Ducks in the third period.
Well, we do not know what happened to Anthony Stolarz, but 28-year-old Thomas Hodges, who was born in England and moved to the United States when he was 12 years of age, has been the emergency backup here in Dallas since 2019. Last played his only professional game for the Allen Americans, which is north of Dallas here.
East Coast League.
5 years ago. 5 years ago he played in one game in the East Coast Hockey League.
So you're saying he's well rested.
This is a strange game, and we're seeing more and more strange happenings. Now Robertson across. Hintz lets it go. Hodges got a piece. He's in the game, and he's made a save.
I think the crowd here at American Airlines Center is pulling for Hodges.
Keep it in. He'll come out of the corner. Stick handles right to the top of the crease and goes tumbling over. Esso Lindell, and the puck comes all the way back to Hodges, who carefully steers it aside and guides it to Kevin Shattenkirk.
And the crowd gives him a cheer.
They're living on a prayer at American Airlines Center. This one's lobbed in and grabbed off by the glove hand of Hodges. He'll hold on. Corner, and that will do it. The Stars get the win tonight by a final count of 4-2. And Tyler Seguin picked up the puck, Hazy, and gave it to Adam Henrique. I'm thinking that he's going to give that puck to Thomas Hodges.
No, I got a feeling he will, too. Hodges does the job. The guys did a fantastic job in front of him.
All the Stars players, of course, know him from practices. So he gets some high fives from all of them. Our final score tonight at American Airlines Center in Dallas. The Stars 4, the Ducks 2.
Situation like this where you have some NHL superstars face-to-face, Jack Campbell takes control of that puck and covers up. As Matt Berlin looks like he's getting set to come on the ice, and there he is with the Golden Bears pads. Getting a standing ovation here from the Oilers faithful. 25-year-old Matt Berlin, born in Edmonton, 6'3", 205 pounds. Third season with the University of Alberta Golden Bears. Also played in the AJHL with the Sherwood Park Crusaders. What a memorable moment this is going to be. 2:20 now left on the clock in the third period. This puck goes sky high and a souvenir for some fans here at Rogers Place.
He just got a bath from Jack Campbell on the bench here, as he's pretty hot in his gear and the water bottle. But good stick there to deflect that one up over top of the glass on an attempted one-timer.
That's coming up next weekend.
Oh, this is pretty cool. And Berlin taking a little skate around, and why not soak it all up, get the legs going. I'm sure there's a little bit of nerves going on in his body right now, so keep moving. Hasn't faced a shot yet. Pretty good defense in front of him to not allow that to happen, but still a minute and 5 seconds left on the clock.
And we've entered the final minute of play here in the third period. Oilers leading by 4. Jones, a shot, blocker stop from Matt Berlin. And the fans are loving it, as I'm sure is Matt Berlin. And the Oilers fans showing their appreciation. Final score 7-3.
Wow, this is great. I like this a lot. Great call by the Oilers to do this, and the coaching staff to give him an opportunity to step on that ice. It's the dream of every kid that plays the game. And he gets to go in there for a couple of minutes. And I'll tell you what, this will be a story for the rest of his life. And who knows, down the road, maybe he'll continue to play. He's playing at the University of Alberta right now. And you never know. Derek Ryan, a player on this Oilers team, went that route, played for the U of A for 4 years, went overseas and came back, and has now played over 400 games. So you really never know when you're going to get your opportunity, but a pretty feel-good moment here at the end of this game.
And as you mentioned, this is something he's going to remember for the rest of his life. And Vinny Desharnais congratulating Matt Berlin, who not only made an appearance, made a save in the game. And the Edmonton Oilers all smiles, and they are heading into the All-Star break and their bye week in bright spirits. 7-0-1 in their past 8 points in eight straight. Don't forget to stick around for after hours, as Vinny Desharnais and Jack Campbell are the guests with Scott and Louie. And of course, Ron and the Hockey Night in Canada panel will be back to wrap. Final score here in Edmonton, the Oilers victorious over the Blackhawks, 7-3.
Thank you very much, Ron. Yes, Matt, one save in 2 minutes and 26 seconds of playing time, and it's enough to have you remembered as an NHL player the rest of your life. How's your heart rate?
It's pretty high. I won't lie, I was probably pushing 140 when I skated out there, but, you know, a big high five from Campbell, and it's good to go. Yeah.
All right, let's go back to how you got the call today to be the backup tonight.
I got a text from Sean in the morning, and he was saying that we need a e-bug tonight, so I was like, yeah, absolutely. I figured I was just going to be sitting in the stands, and then about 4:30 p.m., I get a text from Sean again, and he goes, change of plans.
Sean May?
Sean May, yeah.
Oilers PR guy.
Yeah, and he goes, change of plans, you're actually backing up tonight. And now I'm scramble mode, I got to sign a little contract and do all this stuff before I go. So yeah, it was a bit of a whirlwind, but it was so exciting, I couldn't believe it. Yeah.
And then what were you told on the bench about getting ready to go in?
Oh, that was like, I thought they were kidding, to be honest. It was like 5 or 7 minutes left there. They go, yeah, you're going with 2 minutes, and I'm like, oh, like, good one, yeah, nice. And then they're like, no, seriously, like, I don't joke around. So, and then they go, just be ready to go at 3 minute mark, and then after the first whistle after the 3 minutes, you're going in. And I was like, okay, I guess we're doing this. Yeah.
Okay, you made a save, which you'll be able to tell your grandchildren about years from now. Let's have a look at it, and you take us through it.
I think it was actually maybe missing the net, or maybe not. I don't know. But no, the guys did a great job boxing out there.
It was on Caleb Jones.
Yeah, I actually played against him in the Western League, so I've seen his shot before.
And you acknowledge the fans. Look at that.
Yeah.
Like a sage veteran.
Yeah. No, it was super exciting. I was a little bit shaky, I won't lie. I didn't know if I wanted a shot, but yeah, no, I'll definitely remember that for the rest of my life.
You watched Stuart Skinner burst into prominence this year for the Edmonton Oilers. You played with him at the Southside Athletic Club. Did you ever think, as you watched him succeed this season, that one day you'd be wearing an Oilers uniform?
No, it's quite remarkable, actually, how we've stayed buddies throughout this whole time, and it's kind of funny that he goes down and I come in. So it's, I don't know, the hockey world's small, but it's a pretty cool moment.
What a night. Thanks for your time, Matt. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that.